Tiwonge Gondwe. I'm one of the members of the Kilimanjaro Initiative representing Southern Africa, coming here for the Conference of Land Policy in Africa. This land conference for me has taken me a milestone. It has given me energy, given me the capacity to engage, to influence the policies, and also to engage more on how the SADC and the Maputo Declaration and the Malabo Declaration can work in our region. But most especially, for the country where I'm coming from, the issue of corruption is high. And that's why it's one of the least developed countries in Africa. I'll talk about the experience which I have. Our land policies, the frameworks are very good in paper, but not in practice. And you can agree with me, in the southern region, like Zambia, Zimbabwe, we talk about land, we talk about policies, they are good, yes, but the implementation. Even inside the land, a very good example of the customary land in my country. Now it's on pilot phase, but the corruption is there. We have the land governance committee, the land tribunal governance committee. 4 women are representing and 2 men. But the women who are representing in that committee, they really face challenges on corruption. When we talk of land, we talk of an asset. We talk of a capital. And we talk of the political will in this kind of land. That's where corruption comes in. And this corruption is one of the reasons why African heads of state didn't want to influence or to implement very good forces in their workplace. And the other thing which has influenced me is that everyone talks about implementation. Everyone talks about implementation. But the how part, the financing part, and how to deal with the corruption issues. What makes this conference different with other conferences which have been there? So we need to take stock and we need to say, okay, if this part of head of state or nationality has corrupt practices, what measures are we taking into consideration to make sure that they are not doing the same? We need to take those people on board. We talk of transparency and accountability. If we are talking transparency and accountability on just mouth and paper and not on practical, corruption will not end. We need to end corruption by taking actions and shaming, naming the ones who are corrupting. So by this way, we will finish the corruption. And when we talk of corruption, look at a woman. A woman is a vulnerable group, one of the vulnerable group. The woman is the one who produces food, but she has less capital, she has no land. And the issue of corruption comes in again. So we are making women vulnerable and vulnerable. And the issue of land is in the hands of the rich people, those who hold power, and those are the ones who are promoting corruption. So, yeah, this meeting enhances me to see the ways on how I will influence my voice at community level, on how I will influence my voice at national level, and how I will influence my voice at regional level and globally. Thank you.